So that song, which is really one of my favorite songs of all, probably from the Grateful Dead, is another case where a lot of the ideas in that guitar arrangement come from not only the two guitars, and there's a bunch of things adapted from the lead guitar in there, but also from the bass, a little bit even from the pedal steel on the original recording. I find that on guitar, and you know, I've been interviewing guitarists for decades now for Acoustic Guitar Magazine, and had the chance to interview both Jerry Garcia and Bob Weir at different times. But I'm convinced that so much of the most original guitar music comes from guitarists not listening to other guitarists, but stealing ideas from other instruments. You know, they're listening to piano, they're listening to horns, they're trying to make something, trying to get fiddle ornaments happening on the guitar.
What tuning do you do?
Yeah, the tuning. Drop D tuning again on that song. Six string tuned down to D. And the original of that is in E, so that was another case where I dropped the key. And I took things that are voiced up higher, chords that are voiced up higher normally, and put like D and D major 7 and D7, and put it really down in the bass register on the guitar. And that just came from a lot of experimenting. When I'm arranging a song, I would typically try not go into it with any foregone conclusions about how I'm going to play it, but try it in different tunings, move the capo around, try it in, not just to change the key necessarily, but to even just have different fingerings available in different spots on the neck. You know, going to different places on the guitar and seeing what do I have available here? Because anywhere you could choose to play a song on the guitar, and as you know, you could take any given chord and you could play it in so many different spots. You know, each place you would do it makes certain things easier, makes certain things harder. There's a lot of, that's where the puzzle part of arranging comes from. It's kind of figuring out, if I set it up this way, what becomes available. Yeah.
We don't necessarily know that, so thank you.
Yeah. All right. So I think about what bass notes do I have available in different positions. Where can I play the melody on the guitar? This is something that I think guitarists really tend to underutilize, is just playing the melody of a song. I think whenever you're learning a song, try not only to figure out where the chords are, but then figure out where are the melody notes in relation to the chords where you're playing it. Maybe there's some little melodic licks you can add in. You can echo the melody, you can double the melody, things like that. Guitar is such a rhythm instrument often that that gets overlooked a lot. But I'm always looking for what can become available in different spots on the guitar. So, switch gears out of Grateful Dead land here for a minute. And do a nod to a very different inspiration for me, Stevie Wonder. Growing up, I just loved the grooves and the melodies of Stevie Wonder, and I kind of always wanted to try to do one of his songs, perform one of his songs, but I tell you, he's one of those artists that very hard to take on that way. He's such a unique voice. You know, he's not a guitarist. I can't possibly imitate him in so many respects. So, and to get up here on a stage and play a song like that, I have to find a way to make it feel like mine in some ways. It's not just somebody else's song, but it's got to feel like something that I am bringing something to myself. So, I decided to try this song, Higher Ground. And my MO when I'm going to arrange a song is to listen a lot to it and try to pick up nuances of it, and even better, listen to a lot of different versions of it, because then that can kind of crack open my idea about what a song could be. You know, even interesting covers of a song, maybe another artist heard it in a really different way. And then stop listening and let the arrangement evolve into something that's like what I would play. Because I think that's really important, because we can't be other people, and you know, at some point you gotta translate it to be your own thing. So after a ton of experimentation, capo positions, tunings, I arrived at this.
Cause it won't